we're about to take you on a journey. A journey that will literally take us to the edge. Nearly 64% of Pacific people in New Zealand are obese. It's a serious issue in our community. We're completely overweight and things have to change. So we've decided to put our money where our mouth is and walk the talk.
Resisting hard out, just do not want to do any kind of exercise at all.
I just looked at her and went, you shouldn't be eating that.
I'm just gonna see if Mom wants to come and join me this morning, please.
I was amazed when she showed up because she's already said that she doesn't like exercise.
Great hair and time, man. I'm gonna do this.
Sorry, this is going to pinch. John Utama is morbidly obese according to his BMI.
I'm so big I can die any minute.
For John Utama, the last few weeks have been hell.
It's week three for my training program. I should be feeling better, but actually I'm not.
With the support of his family, he's sticking to a strict training regime.
Come on, Dad. I'm proud of you. Keep going.
With this dedication, it's time to check John's fitness.
We're here back for a beep test and strength test again. Last time I did this, it was gut busting and real tough. It took me the entire session just to do the strength test. So I guess the goal for me now is to improve on that and get to the peak test.
His hard work seems to be paying off.
Come on, Dad, we can do this, Dad. We're almost there. No, come on.
Eight, come on, you go.
Go, Dad, one more.
Last time it took me 42 minutes to do the strength test. So, I'm happy I beat that.
Fighting through the pain, he's achieving much better results this time round.
Start level 1-1.
Even making it to the beep test.
Level 3-4, 3-5, 3-6.
Really, okay, like we did last time. Okay. Don't worry about the beeps, you're just going to keep moving.
Level 3-7.
That was my first beep test. Didn't make it to the last one, so I'm happy I got somewhere. I've got a mark to improve on next time.
It's not long before John has to prove himself again. His trainer wants him to push even harder.
And Saturday morning rolled around and we went to Bethel's. I just couldn't believe how high that dune was, and I knew we were going to run to the top of that damn thing.
Anyone want to be on our team?
Where's the useless teams? Yeah,
on this one too.
Let's go.
Top one.
At this session, the team are expected to run up the dunes at least 30 times. Some workmates have tagged along in support of John.
My legs feel like jelly, a little wobbly. The very first hill was a killer.
One down, 29 to go, and John's almost had enough.
You know, I was thinking, man, I ain't never going to get to the top of this thing. I'm going to roll down and just stand in the water or go home, take my bag and kick the sand in his face and go home.
So, go on, mate.
But his wife Irene's there to stop him from breaking.
Well, this is his first time that he's done this, so obviously it's really hard. But what he's achieved so far has actually been really, really good.
Irene's been like a safety blanket for me. I love having her there to encourage me on, because if she isn't, I'll be in my car, taking off out of there.
Come on, John, let's go. Keep going. Push it. You're almost there.
A few times I had to look down at her going, what am I doing here? Please take me home. But to her credit, she was yelling at me and screaming at me to keep running. And, you know, sometimes when you're in my shape, that's a good thing to have.
And while John is struggling, a much fitter and lighter Nari makes easy work of the dunes.
It must be really tough for John because he's carrying almost me again. I did feel sorry for him a little bit, and then I thought, well, you know, he's worked himself into that situation, so he's got to work himself out. Even though I'm running past him, he's toughing it out, and I'm so proud of him. I think it's amazing.
The sand dunes was giving me nightmares the night before, and the reality was just as bad. I sort of gave myself a pat on the back that I came through that. I was just thinking, actually, this, you know, 4 or so weeks through the training, I don't feel too bad. I thought my legs would be seized up by now, and apart from a sore back and a bruised ego, it wasn't too bad.
That's it.
Next time, on Walk the Talk.
Still stuck to my food, still enjoying watching those kilos melt away, regardless of what the nutrition said.
Just noticed that you've been eating quite a bit of egg yolk. Currently it's at 14 per week, and that's really, really excessive. And the maximum is about 3 to 5.
Yeah, did you see my face?
Yes.
It's like, oh yeah, yeah, but I'm still gonna do it. I hear what you're saying, but I'm gonna do it.